Hello everyone, welcome back to Nagesh Karaske Oracle School. Students, in our last session we have seen addition of like fraction. How to do the addition of like fractions? Yes, to do the addition, what we have to do? Just we have to add the numerators and the denominator remains the same. In this way we have seen how to do the addition of like fraction. Now today we are going to see the subtraction of like fractions. So open your textbook, page number 31. Look at the board here. Subtraction of like fractions. Subtraction of like fractions with the same denominator can be done in the same way as addition. How we have done the addition of like fractions? In the same way only we have to do the subtraction also. Now we will see one activity. Take a slab of chocolate or a fraction strip, divide it into 5 equal parts. Now here you can see one chocolate is there. Okay, now this whole chocolate you have to divide into 5 equal parts. Here you can see this chocolate is divided into 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the fraction of this chocolate is 5 by 5. Okay. Now what you have to do? Give 2 of the parts, that is 2 by 5, to one friend. See. Now out of this whole chocolate you have to give 2 parts of this chocolate to your one of the friend. So what is the fraction of the chocolate which is given to your friend? 2 by 5. Okay. Then see here, give 2 of the parts, that is 2 by 5, to your friend. Then 3 parts, that is 3 by 5, remains. Now see here, if you will give 2 by 5 part of the chocolate to your friend, then how many parts will remains? Yes, if you will give 2 parts, see here. Here 5 parts are there. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now out of these 5 parts, if you will give 2 parts to your friend, then 1, 2, 3, these 3 parts will remain. So what part of the chocolate is remaining? 3 by 5. Fraction of the chocolate is 3 by 5, which is remain. Okay, now see here, 3 parts, that is 3 by 5, remains. Therefore 5 by 5 minus 2 by 5 means what? See, out of this total chocolate, full chocolate, okay, from this whole chocolate, if you will give 2 parts to your friend, then 3 parts will remain. So 5 by 5 minus 2 by 5 is equal to what? Like addition only, we have to subtract the numerators only. Okay, here 5 minus 2 you have to do, and the denominator which is 5, that is a same denominator in both the fraction. So denominator remains same, only you have to subtract the numerator. So here 5 minus 2 if you will do, then you will get the fraction 3 by 5. Now from that 3 by 5, again you have to give 1 by 5 to another friend. Now see here, this is 3 by 5. Yes, this is 3 by 5. Now from this chocolate, you have to give 1 part to your another friend. If you will give this 1 part to your friend, then these 2 parts will remain. Okay, so what is the fraction of the remaining chocolate now? 2 by 5. And how you got this answer 2 by 5? Yes, from 3 by 5 minus 1 by 5, if we will do, then we will get the answer 2 by 5. That is the fraction of the chocolate which is remain. Okay, now from the remaining means 3 by 5, you have to give 1 by 5 to your friend. Then 2 by 5 is left. Therefore, 3 by 5 minus 1 by 5 means what? 3 minus 1 divided by 5 is equal to 2 by 5. Means here only simple you have to do the subtraction of numerators only. Denominator remains same. Only you have to do the subtraction of numerators. So in this way we will see the subtraction of like fraction. Now turn your page. Next page. Here some of the examples that given us. After that we will see the exercise. First example, see the 4 by 8 minus 2 by 8. 4 by 8 minus 2 by 8. Now see in the first fraction, what is the denominator? Here the denominator is 8. Okay. Then see the second fraction, here also the denominator is 8. Means these two fractions are like fractions because here the denominator is same. And now we have to do the subtraction of these like fractions. So how will you do? See here, if the fractions are like fractions, then while doing the addition, you have to do the addition of only numerator, and also while subtraction also you have to do the subtraction of numerator parts only. So here 4 by 8 minus 2 by 8 is equal to 4 minus 2 by 8. The denominator remains the same, only we have to subtract the numerators. 4 minus 2 we have to do. Okay, now 4 minus 2, yes, 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. So what is the answer? 2 by 8. 4 by 8 minus 2 by 8 is equal to 2 by 8. Now see the another second example here. 3 by 6 minus 2 by 6 is equal to, how will you solve this example? Yes, only we will see the numerator. What is the numerator in the first fraction? 3 is the numerator and 6 is the denominator. Now see the other fraction, second fraction. Here in this fraction 2 is the numerator and 6 is the denominator. Now subtract the numerators only. 3 minus 2 by 6. 3 minus 2, yes, 1. So what is the answer? 1 by 6. Clear this? Okay. Now we'll move to the third example. Look at the board here. In the third example, what are the fractions? 7 by 10 minus 3 by 10. Now see this fraction 7 by 10. In this fraction, what is the numerator? Here 7 is the numerator. And what is the denominator? Denominator is 10. 7 by 10 minus 3 by 10. How will you read this? 3 by 10. Okay. Now see, again denominator is same, so this is like fraction. Now what we will do? Yes, 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3 by 10. Okay. Now 7 minus 3, do the subtraction and tell me the answer. 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. So the fraction is 4 by 10. 7 by 10 minus 3 by 10 is equal to 4 by 10. In this way you can solve this example. One more example that given us, fourth number, we will see that also. 5 by 7 minus 2 by 7 is equal to. Now in the box, first of all, what you will write? Yes, 5. 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 by 7. Now tell me this answer. 5 minus 2, 3. 3 by 7. This will be your answer. 5 by 7 minus 2 by 7 is equal to 3 by 7. In this way, we will solve all the examples from the exercise 2.10. Okay. See the first question. A question, fill in the blanks. 5 by 9 minus 2 by 9 is equal to. Now here 5 by 9 minus 2 by 9 is equal to 5 minus, what will come here? Yes, see the second fraction. In the second fraction, what is the numerator? 2. Okay, so 5 minus 2 by 9. Say 5 minus 2 by 9. Now do the subtraction. 5 minus 2, where is it? Is 3 by 9. So what is the answer? 3 by 9. Clear? Okay. Now see the second one. 6 by 7 minus 3 by 7. 6 by 7 minus 3 by 7 is equal to, what you will write first? Yes, what will come here? 6, correct. 6 minus 3 by 7. Now do the subtraction. 6 minus 3 is equal to, yes, show your 6 fingers. From the 6 fingers you have to cut your 3 fingers. Okay, close your 3 fingers. Then how many fingers are remaining? 3. So what is the answer? 3 by 7. 6 by 7 minus 3 by 7 is equal to 3 by 7. Okay. Next, 3 by 7 minus 2 by 7. What you will do here? 3 minus 2 by 7. Only we have to do the subtraction in the numerator parts. Okay. 3 by 7 minus 2 by 7 is equal to 3 minus 2 by 7. Now 3 minus 2, 1. So 1 by 7 is the answer. Next example, fourth number, 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. See, you have to read the fraction 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. In this way, you have to read all the fractions in your mind. 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. So, how will you solve this example? Yes, what we will do? We will just subtract the numerators part. Okay, 3 minus 1 by 4. Now, what is the 3 minus 4? Sorry, 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. 2 by 4. Now see this fifth example. 6 by 8 minus 2 by 8. 6 by 8 minus 2 by 8 is equal to, yes, what are the numerators? 6 minus 2 by 8. Now 6 minus 2 is equal to what? 4. Correct. So the answer is 4 by 8. See this sixth example. 4 by 5 minus 2 by 5. 4 by 5 minus 2 by 5. What we will do here? 4 minus 2 we will do. Okay. And the denominator 5 will remain same. 4 minus 2 is equal to? Yes. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. So here the answer is 2 by 5. Next example, seventh number, here 7 by 10 minus 2 by 10. So what we will do? First we will do 7 minus 2 by 10. Denominator remains the same. 7 minus 2 by 10. Now do the subtraction. 7 minus 2, yes, 5, correct. 5 by 10. Next, 5 by 11 minus 3 by 11. Yes, 5 by 11 minus 3 by 11. Solve this example, 5 minus 3 by 11. In this way you have to solve. 5 minus 3, yes, 5 minus 3. How many are remaining? 2 are remaining. Okay, so the answer is 2 by 11. This denominator will remain the same only. Next, 8 by 11 minus 3 by 11. Again, 8 minus 3 by 11. Now from 8, cut your 3 fingers or close your 3 fingers. First of all, show your 8 fingers to me. From that, close your 3 fingers. How many fingers are remaining? Yes, 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. So the answer is 5 by 11. Next, 7 by 13 minus 6 by 13. Now here 7 minus 6 by 13. Where is it? Is 7 minus 6? 1. 1 by 13. This is your answer. Next, 9 by 12 minus 5 by 12. Do the subtraction. 9 minus 5 by 12. 9 minus 5? Yes, 4. 4 by 12. Okay. Now one more example is remaining. Last example, 8 by 15 minus 1 by 15. How will you solve this? Yes, 8 minus 1 by 15. 8 minus 1 by 15. Now 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. Correct. So the answer is 7 by 15. So in this way, we have completed question number A. Shall we move to the next question? Question number B. Okay, clear this till question number A. Okay. Next question, question number B. See here, 5/6 minus 2/6 is equal to, here you have to give equal sign, okay? Here you have to give equal sign, 5/6 minus 2/6. How will you solve this? 5 minus 2 by 6. Now 5 minus 2 is equal to what? Again you have to give equal to sign. 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. 3/6. Okay? Next. 9/10 minus 5/10. 9/10 minus 5/10. First you give equal to sign. Okay? Then do the subtraction. 9 minus 5/10 is equal to 9 minus 5, 4. 4/10. Next, 7/8 minus 1/8 is equal to 7 minus 1/8. 7 minus 1, 6. Correct. 6/8. Next, fourth number, 7/10 minus 3/10 is equal to 7/10 minus 3/10. Yes, how will you solve? 7 minus 3/10 is equal to 4/10. Next, fifth number, 7/30 minus 3/30 is equal to 7 minus 3/30 is equal to 7 minus 3. Yes, tell me the answer. 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. Correct. 4/30. Next, 5/9 minus 3/9 is equal to, denominator will remains the same, so we'll write here 9 first and then 5 minus 3, means 5 minus 3/9 is equal to 5 minus 3, 2. So the answer is 2/9. Next, 9/10 minus 1/10. Now 9/10 minus 1/10 is equal to 9 minus 1/10 is equal to 9 minus 1, 8, 8/10. Next, 8th number, 9 minus 8 by 9 is equal to 9 minus 8, 1, 1/9. Next, 3/4 minus 1/4 is equal to 3/4 minus 1/4. 3 minus 1/4 is equal to 3 minus 1, 2. So the answer is 2/4. Next, 10th number. Yes, 7/8 minus 1/8 is equal to 7 minus 1/8 is equal to 7 minus 1, 6. 6/8. Next, 3/5 minus 2/5 is equal to, yes, how will you solve? 3 minus 2/5 is equal to 1/5. Next, 5/6 minus 2/6 is equal to 5 minus 2/6. Now 5 minus 2, yes, do the subtraction. 5 minus 2, 3. 3/6, this is your answer. Next, 3/4 minus 2/4. Yes, is equal to 3 minus 2/4 is equal to 3 minus 2. Yes, 1, 1/4. Next, 4/5 minus 2/5 is equal to 4 minus 2/5 is equal to 4 minus 2, 2. 2/5. Next, 5 by 7 minus 2 by 7 is equal to 5 minus 2 by 7 is equal to 3 by 7. Next, 16 number 7 by 7 minus 6 by 7 is equal to, yes, 7 minus 6 by 7 is equal to 1 by 7. Okay, clear till here? Okay, now see the next page. Next page, few more examples are remaining. See here, 5 by 12 minus 3 by 12 is equal to, yes, 5 by 12 minus 3 by 12, how will you solve? Yes, 5 minus 3 by 12 is equal to 5 minus 3, 2. So what is the answer? 2 by 12. Next, 6 by 11 minus 5 by 11 is equal to, yes, 6 by 11 minus 5 by 11 is equal to 6 minus 5 by 11 is equal to 6 minus 5, 1. So what is the fraction? 1 by 11. Next, 3 by 5 minus 1 by 5 is equal to 3 minus 1 by 5. Now 3 minus 1, 2. So the answer is 2 by 5. Next, read the fraction. 5 by 7 minus 4 by 7. How will you solve this? Yes, 5 minus 4 by 7 is equal to 1 by 7. Next, 6 by 7 minus 4 by 7 is equal to, yes, 6 minus 4 by 7. Do the subtraction. 6 minus 4 is equal to, 6 minus 4 is equal to 2, 2 by 7. Next, 4 by 4 minus 1 by 4 is equal to 4 minus 1, 4 minus 1 by 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 3 by 4. Next, see the next fraction, 3 by 8 minus 2 by 8, 3 by 8 minus 2 by 8 is equal to, yes, what you will do? 3 minus 2 by 8 is equal to, now 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So what is the fraction? 1 by 8. Now see the last one. 5 by 7 minus 1 by 7. Now students, in this fraction, tell me, see the first fraction, 24th number last example. In this last example, 5 by 7, in this fraction, what is the numerator? Yes, what is the numerator? 5 is the numerator. And what is the denominator? 7 is the denominator. Yes, 5 is the numerator, 7 is the denominator. Now see the second fraction from the same example, 1 by 7. Okay, now in this fraction 1 by 7, what is the numerator? 1. Numerator means upper part. Okay, the part which is taken away, that is called as numerator. And what is the denominator? Denominator means what? Yes, total parts of the fraction. Okay, or the fraction is divided into how many parts, that part, that number of parts are called as denominator. Here this fraction, this whole is divided into 7 equal parts. So in this fraction 7 is the denominator, and from that 7, one part is taken away. So 1 is the numerator. So numerator means what? The part which is taken away, that is called as numerator. And the denominator means what? Denominator means total number of parts in which the whole is divided, that is called as denominator. Okay, say along with me, denominator means what? The total parts in which the whole is divided is called as denominator. And what is mean by numerator? Numerator is nothing but the parts which is taken away, that is called as numerator. Now see this fraction 1 by 7. What is the numerator? 1 is the numerator. And what is the denominator? 7 is the denominator. Now do the subtraction. 5 by 7 minus 1 by 7 is equal to, yes, 5 minus 1 by 7. Now 5 minus 1, yes, 5 minus 1, 4. 4 by 7. Clear? How to do the subtraction? Okay. So, in this way, today we have seen exercise 2.10. Okay. So, what we have seen today? We have seen how to do the subtraction of like fraction. So, in this way, we have completed exercise 2.10. In the next session, we will see the next part. Till that time, take care. Bye-bye.